The World Economic Forum at the beginning of the year released a report on the future of jobs, predicting that changes caused by technological advances and the fourth industrial revolution will lead to 7 million jobs lost by year 2020. Well, partially offsetting that will be the creation of 2 million new jobs. But still, 5 million of us jobless. What do we do in the face of the new technological revolution? New jobs, new opportunities, new training? Part 2 of our three-part series with Kwon Jang-ho.
Technologies, industries, and jobs have all come and gone in a world that has always been changing. And now another change is coming. It's the fourth industrial revolution, and it's fueled by quickly advancing technologies such as artificial intelligence, robotics, and nanotechnology, all held together by big data.
The essence of the fourth industrial revolution is big data and incorporating that into AI technology, IoT hardware, and robotics. It will bring smarter and better services and change many industries from finance to law.
The growing importance of data can be seen in a list from 2015 of the most in-demand job skills worldwide. Number 2 was statistical analysis and data mining, and it was the only skill in the top 4 of all countries that were analyzed. Its popularity can be attributed in part to the current lack of supply compared to demand. This is best illustrated in Korea, where the number of people in data-related work is said to need an increase of 20,000 or 20% to match industry demand. To get a better grasp of the situation, I visited a data analytics company in Seoul that is currently looking to hire more data scientists.
In the last 5 years, data, especially social media data, has grown in importance, but there's so much of it, it's hard to handle. But because it's an urgent issue, companies are looking to hire people right now, and there aren't enough qualified people out there.
If that's the case, why aren't there more people trying to get into the field? I wanted to see if I could get in on the action.
Say I came to your office one day and said, I want to become a data scientist too. Would it be possible? What advice would you give?
There are many ways to become a data scientist, but actually the most important thing is having experience working in a company or industry to better understand and interpret the data. And, of course, you need to have studied statistics, engineering, or computer science at university. But a U.S. expert once said you need a minimum 5 to 8 years in the field experience to become an elementary-level data scientist.
So it's safe to say I won't be becoming a data scientist anytime soon. But data is not the only field coming out of the fourth industrial revolution.
I'm here at a 3D printing school in Seoul, where one of the students has kindly made us this Arirang logo. Through the courses, they can learn everything from designing 3D prints to making the machines themselves, and it can even count towards a professional 3D printing certification.
With 3D printing becoming simpler, cheaper, and more reliable, more and more individuals and companies are making use of it, opening up a new industry.
I studied computers and product design, and that's how I learned about 3D printing. I was supposed to get ready to get a job, but I thought this was a great opportunity. By learning about 3D printing, I feel like I'm investing in my future.
I ran a business for 25 years, and I was getting ready to retire. I think this course will give me a new lease of life. Through this opportunity, I can develop and make new things. I believe this is something I can do even into my old age.
Opportunities can be expected to grow in other sectors as well, from computing to robotics. And although many of the jobs we know today will disappear, it's something that cannot be avoided.
It was the same 100 years ago. Jobs that were around then aren't here anymore. Changes in society will create new jobs. That will mean re-education is needed. Education and schools will need to change. But it's an issue we will have to face and adapt to, and not one we should fear.
Kwon Jang-ho, Arirang News.